Hello everybody, myself Shankar Kataria, PGT Physics, JNV. In our daily lives, we use many apparatus. One of them is glasses, which we wear if we have a defect in our eye. Some of us have seen microscopes and telescopes fitted with eyepiece. A goldsmith uses a magnifying glass to view the properties of the metal. And of course, we see with our eyes. Can we identify anything common between all of them? Yes, the common thing is a convex lens. And today's topic of our discussion is image formation by a convex lens and how it is used in our daily lives. At the end of the session, you would be able to draw the image and apply it in your daily life. Let us see our first case, how a lens can be used in a camera. So we have a convex lens. Here we have F1, 2F1, and we consider an object which is placed at infinity. So the ray coming from the object passing through the optical center would go undeviated. Here we have second principal focus and this is our 2F2. Another ray which is parallel to the previous ray would converge and meet, both the rays would meet at point F2. So hence the image is formed in the focal plane in case rays are parallel to each other. If they are parallel to the principal axis, they would meet at focus. Next, we will see that how our convex lens is used in spectacles. So we have a convex lens and we have optical center. This is F1, this is 2F1, here we have F2 and here we have 2F2. Now the object is placed beyond 2F1, so a ray coming parallel to the principal axis would pass through the focus, and another ray which is passing through the optical center would go undeviated. Both these rays, they are meeting between F2 and 2F2. So our object is formed between F2 and 2F2. The image is formed between F2 and 2F2 in case our object is beyond 2F1. Third case is how a convex lens can be used in a terrestrial telescope. So here we have a lens and let the object be now placed at 2F1. So we will see that what happens to the image. So our object AB is placed at 2F1. A ray parallel to the principal axis passes through the focus. Another ray from the optical center would go undeviated. So we see that they meet at 2F2. So hence, object at 2F1, image at 2F2. Next is again another case where the lens can be used in spectacles. We have a convex lens and here is our F1, this is our 2F1. Now our object will be more closer to the lens, that is between F1 and 2F1. In that case, we will see that the image now is formed beyond 2F2. So here we have a ray which is coming parallel to the principal axis, would pass through the focus. Another ray which is passing through the optical center, and both these rays are meeting at a point which is beyond the point 2F2. So hence, if object is between F1 and 2F1, the image is between beyond 2F2. Next, we will see that how this convex lens is used in a simple microscope. Here now we have a lens. This is the principal axis. Now our object is situated at F1, that is at the focus of the lens. In this case, we would see that the rays coming parallel to the principal axis would go through the focus of the lens. Another ray which is passing through the principal through the optical center would go undeviated. So here we see that these rays, they go to infinity. So if the object is at f1, the image is formed at infinity. Next and the most important case is like when the lens can be used in a simple microscope and by a Goldsmith as a magnifying glass. So this case, we bring the object even more closer to the lens. So now our lens and our object will be now between focus and the optical center of the lens. So here we have a ray parallel to the principal axis which will pass through the focus. Another ray passing through the optical center would go undeviated. Now these rays, they are not meeting beyond this lens on the right hand side. Hence we need to produce them at the back, and here we would get a virtual and erect image different from those which were formed in previous cases. All those images were real and inverted, while this image is virtual and erect. Now the same we can observe on an optical bench. Here we have the object which is at 2f1. The image is of same size and real and inverted, obtained at 2f2. If the object goes beyond 2f1, we need to bring the screen between f2 and 2f2 to view the sharp image. If the object comes between f1 and 2f1, we need to take the screen beyond 2f2 to view a sharp enlarged image. If the object comes at f1, we need to take this screen farther for viewing the image of the flame, and that would be considered at infinity. If the object comes between f1 and optical center of the lens, then we will not be able to obtain a real image, because in this case the image would be virtual and erect. Okay, we will now review what we have studied. So we had position of object and position of image, nature of image, size and use. So if the object was at infinity, the image is at focus, nature is real and inverted, and size is highly diminished, and this is used in camera, can be used. Beyond 2f1, the image comes between f2 and 2f2. Again, it is real and inverted, but now it is just diminished. And this can be used in spectacles. When the object is at 2f1, image is at 2f2. Again, it is real and inverted, but it is of same size. And this is used in terrestrial telescope. When the object is between f1 and 2f1, the image goes beyond 2f2. Again, it is real and inverted, but now it becomes enlarged. And this also is used in spectacles. If the object is at f1, the image goes to infinity, and it is now again real and inverted, and it is highly enlarged now. And this property of this lens is used in simple microscopes. Then if the object is between f1 and 2f1, then the image is formed on the same side. It is virtual and erect, and it is again enlarged, and this is used as a magnifying glass by Goldsmith.